today we'll be going over chapter 11.1, where we'll be covering simple trig identities. So I want to introduce two identities to you. We have five in total that we're going to go through this lesson. First one is tan theta is equal to sine theta over cosine, and vice versa. Second one, which is our Pythagorean identity, comes in very handy. Sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 1, and again, vice versa. The reason I say this comes in handy is because you can manipulate this, and quite often this helps out in proving identities. Just for example, you can have sine squared theta is equal to 1 minus cosine squared theta, right? Works out, and you know what sine squared theta is equivalent to, and vice versa. You can also say, for example, cosine squared theta is equal to 1 minus sine squared theta. Okay, so you might have to manipulate these depending on your problem. All right, example one. Example one says, given that x is equal to 2 sine theta and y is equal to cosine theta plus 1, show that x squared plus 4 in parentheses y minus 1 squared is equal to 4. Now, to kind of help us out here, we're going to use one of the trig identities that we just talked about. But it's probably a good idea to know what sine theta is individually and what cosine theta is equivalent to as well. So let's go ahead and do that. We're going to do x is equal to 2 sine theta, and let's figure out what sine theta actually is. Well, let's divide by 2, divide by 2. Sine theta ends up being x over 2. Well, that's great. We know what sine theta is. Let's go ahead and figure out what cosine theta is. Okay? So cosine theta says y is equal to cosine theta plus 1 minus 1 minus 1. I know that cosine theta is equal to y minus 1. Well, this kind of, and I think you can kind of know where I'm going here. Let's use the trig identity that we just talked about, which was sine theta squared plus cosine theta squared is equal to 1. Now, we know what sine theta is. We know what cosine theta is. So hopefully that'll kind of help us show or prove that equation. So sine theta, that is x squared, or x over 2 squared, cosine theta being y minus 1 squared. Okay, let's go ahead and simplify. This ends up being x squared over 4. Let's keep this the way it is. Again, always reflect back on what you're trying to show. They haven't simplified here, so it's probably a good idea for us to not simplify. All right, we have a fraction here. To get rid of that fraction, let's multiply everything by 4. And again, always look back on what you're trying to prove. Okay, so this cancels out. This
cancels out. We end up having x squared plus 4, 1 minus y squared. And then 4 times 1 is equal to 4. So did we actually prove what we needed to prove? We did. Okay? So again, we're using that trig
identity to help us out to show this equation. All right, so I do want to introduce your third trig identity. Now, do recall, what will help us out here is some of our inverse trig ratios. Now, as you do recall, secant, well, what is secant equivalent to? That would be 1 over cosine theta. Or how about we do cosecant? Cosecant theta is equal to 1 over sine theta. And then finally, cotangent is equivalent to 1 over tan theta. Okay? We do want to focus on this one. Now remember, what did we say about tan theta? What's the first trig identity that we said about tan theta? Now, tan theta is equivalent to sine over cosine. Okay, well, what can we say about cotan? a cotan, which is the inverse of tan, we can simply say, well, what is the inverse of sine and cosine? That would just be cosine theta over sine theta. So cotan, cotangent theta is equal to cosine theta over sine theta. That is the third trig identity that we want to introduce in this video. All right, so I want to introduce the fourth and fifth trig identities that you will have to know by today. Now you should be very familiar with this identity. I showed you that earlier. Now our fourth and fifth can be derived by dividing by cosine squared, which we'll do here. And let's do sine squared theta over here and to find out what our fourth and fifth identities are. So on this side, let's do divide by cosine squared theta. Okay, so each and every term is divided by cosine squared theta. And let's take a look at this. Well, we know this already. So cosine squared over cosine squared, well, that's just one. Okay, sine over cosine, well, in this case, it's sine squared over cosine squared. Again, remind yourself of that identity that I showed you earlier. That would be tan squared theta. And of course, 1 over cosine squared is just 1, sorry, that would be secant squared theta. All right, so that would be the fourth identity that we want you to know. Now, again, we divided by cosine squared here. To find our fifth identity, let's divide by sine squared here. Each and every term. Alright, sine squared over sine squared, that would be 1. Cosine squared over sine squared, now we just talked about this earlier, that would be cotangent squared theta. And what is 1 over sine squared? Well, again, you should be pretty familiar with this. That would just be cosecant squared theta. Okay, and that would be your fifth and actually the final identity that we will have to know by today. Alright, so we have all five of the identities that we talked about in the video. Again, these first two, that was the first two we introduced. These last three we just talked about. You should grow very familiar with it. Again, the more you use them, the better you'll get at it, or the get at applying them. But again, you can manipulate these as well to kind of fit whatever problem you're doing at that time. All right, so before we do the next examples, just some tips to kind of help you along with proving identities. So number one, just simple, just know your identities, know how to use them, know how to apply them. The more you use them, the more you practice, the better you kind of get a handle of what you're looking for. Number two, start with the complicated side, work the complicated side, and using those identities that we kind of learned in this video, and only work on that one side to kind of help you along with how it should look like on the opposite side. So number three, write using this sine theta and cosine theta. Try to use sine and cosine as much as possible because, look, you know six trig ratios by now, and why not just try to use two of them? By using these most often, you can kind of get those patterns or those identities that you're looking for. Number four, check the opposite side for hints. Try to do that constantly, maybe step by step to kind of see how you're doing. And then number five, practice. So practice as much as you can because that is really the only way you can kind of get better at anything, really. But especially with identities, it's something that requires sometimes a little bit of trial and error. So it's something that you do want to consider as far as maybe spending a bit more time on identities than maybe some previous lessons you've done in the past. All right, example three. Example three says, secant x minus cosine x is identical to sine x times tan x. And now again, keep in mind the tips that I kind of talked about earlier. Work the more complicated side in this case. Both are pretty simple, but let's go ahead for this example. Let's work to the left side. Now again, the left side is identical to the right side. We just need to go ahead and prove it. So again, let's talk about secant x. How can we manipulate that? Well, isn't secant x the same thing as cosine x? Right? So 1 over cosine x minus cosine x. Again, if you want to subtract these, they need to have the same denominator, which they don't right now. So let's go ahead and change that by multiplying by cosine x cosine x, right? Well, what do we end up here? So we have 1 over cosine x minus cosine squared over cosine x times 1 is cosine x. Okay, again, we have the same denominator, which is great. Let's put this together in one fraction. So 1 minus cosine squared x over cosine x. Okay, all right. Let's start thinking about this. This seems like a identity similar to one of the identities we talked about earlier. So, let me jog your memory. So sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 1. Again, we can manipulate this. Okay, so sine squared theta is equal to 1 minus cosine squared theta. Okay, so we can change this to looking like sine squared theta. Okay, not theta, but x. All right, again, we have a couple more steps, and now consider we've kind of come a tiny bit. We need to make sure that this looks like that. Okay, so what else can we do? Again, this is sine squared. How about we kind of split that apart? So we have sine x times sine x over cosine x. And again, you can kind of see where I'm going here. Tan is the same thing as sine over cosine. So how about we replace that with just tan? And we have finally proven that my left side is actually, and it is, identical to my right side. Okay, so with the help of identities and kind of taking one step after the other, we can prove that both sides are identical to each other.
It is true, and here we have a true again. Then if P is true and Q is false, we've seen that P implies Q is false. If we look at Q implies P, because Q is false, we cannot say anything about P, so we get it as true. Then if P is false and Q is true, we said that when P is false, we cannot say anything about Q, so we get true here and true here. When Q is true but P is false, we get Q implies P is false, and the last case is true.